cultivated meat will be benefit for the people because it will give them good nutrition, you know, which is limited now by the volume of the production of the animals. Second is the ethical problems because, of course, you know, it's not very nice for the animals to treat them as they are treated and to kill them just to get the food. Third is the health problems, you know, which I believe that the cultivated meat will be healthier than the standard meat, let's say. I'm not talking about the bio breeds, etc. Then there are environmental problems. It's a bigger problem, I guess, than the CO2 emissions. But basically, if we are talking about the nature, then I guess that one of the biggest problems, except of the, let's say, negative externalities, it's also saving place where the crop is being now grown in order to feed the animals, because it's something like 60-70% of the fields is occupied just because of feeding the animals.
We first require a source of the cells, which is an animal, and these cells must subsequently be isolated from the tissue and put in a suitable container, which will provide the cells with the correct temperature, air concentration, and so on. And the cells are fed with a mix of nutrients. They multiply. They can divide approximately once in every day. So after one day, you have twice the number of cells. After 2 days, you have 4 times, 8 times, and so on. So it's an exponential process. This exponential process quite quickly creates the required mass of the cells. After the end of this process, the cells are only what you can call, like, you know, cell mass, or like it's just the raw biomass, which can be used, for example, for making like nugget type products or pet food. But in order to make the true cultivated meat, there is required additionally the step of differentiation on some 3D scaffold, because the cells naturally don't tend to grow into like 3D structures. So we need to provide them something they can hold onto. In this structure, the cells also differentiate into the multinucleated myofibers, which can be found in skeletal muscle. And also other types of cells like adipocytes are present to ensure that the meat will have an adequate quantity of fat.
For the product which would be equal to minced meat, like hamburgers or sausages and things like that, I think it's a question of small number of years, let's say 1, 2, maximum 3 years from now. And the 3D structure, like a steak or something like that, I estimate it something like 5-7 years from now, because it's a little bit complicated to feed the cells and to give them the nutrition and the oxygen in 3D structure, because our tissue is full with the capillaries, so everywhere is blood and nutrition and oxygen, so it's quite hard to mimic that in vitro.
One of our challenges has been myoglobin, which is the protein which gives the red color to meat, for example beef meat. As you can see on one of our samples, without the myoglobin, the cultivated meat has much lighter color. And there are several ways how the myoglobin, or two main ways how the myoglobin can be put into the meat. Either the cells can make it directly, but this only happens in specific conditions. And we are still trying to optimize the conditions to make our cells produce the correct amount of myoglobin. The alternative to this is to produce the myoglobin externally, or, you know, some like alternative, for example, like hemoglobin, which is a plant protein but very closely related to myoglobin, can be used. And this is the method that is used in the plant-based meat substitutes. Notably, myoglobin is not important only for the color, but also for the specific taste of red meats, what differentiates the taste of beef from chicken, for example.
The efficiency of in vitro cultivation in comparison with the, let's say, cultivation of the cells or muscles in the tissue of the living animal, the efficiency could be one third higher than with the animal, because the animal has to heat itself, you know, it breathes, it walks. There is a lot of things which the animal spends the energy and the nutrition to in comparison with in vitro cultivation. We have the calculations that it's very likely that we will get to the operative costs of something around €4 per kilo of the beef meat.